Hello and welcome to another video for Limup.net. Maybe you saw that SD card in my PinePhone there. I'm trying to boot something from SD card again. And this looks like it's going fine. I'm revisiting Slam OS or OpenSUSE here. And there's a nice little chameleon getting color as a boot animation. So this is the first boot. I haven't looked at this before. It's running Fosh, and I think right now it's taking some time to resize the file system so that it can use the whole storage of this SD card, which I inserted. And because that SD card has 64 gigabytes, that might take a while. Now, last time when I looked at it, it was quite buggy. The modem didn't work at all, so I didn't even have to attempt phone calls or something. I think that my last video was sometime in early November, and I hope I still remember the passcode for this. Maybe it's 1234. Yeah. Right, so that's it. And yeah, this looks quite familiar. They are using a different font for some UI elements in Fosh, which is why that clock is looking different from what it usually does. And yeah, so let's go to settings first. Oh, now that's the initial first run wizard, but I can go through that too. Looks like the modem is recognized, so I'm actually going to try and put in my APN so that I can try whether LTE works. Unfortunately, my APN is only sort of supported. Yeah, this is more finicky than it is on other distros. And that's pretty similar to the experience I had when I tried this, well, about 2 months ago, I think. Let me manually add my IP, my provider here, which is really stupid, dirt cheap discounter reseller. Well, not really dirt cheap. They were back in the day. Right now, I think their prices are competitive, but they are not the cheapest option anymore. So let's try and enable mobile data here. And that's actually looking quite good, I think. And let's open the browser and just go on web and go to my blog. Well, maybe I should add that S for HTTPS there. And yeah, the keyboard's white here, like it is on PostmacOS. Doesn't really seem to work. Let's try a more common website. Maybe this one. Yeah. Great. So we've got mobile data working here on OpenSUSE, which is fairly nice. But let's briefly try my blog again because it really should work. And there it is. It apparently loaded just a little bit slowly. And I very recently wrote two blog posts. One is the weekly update, you know, as always. I did that for the 28th. Time here, and I'm actually quite proud of that. I really wouldn't have thought that I would keep this up for so long when I started it. And then I wrote a post about my current setup with Arch Linux ARM or Technics Mobile, and I go through all my the apps I'm using here and partially why and so on. I should have added more links maybe to the projects, but then they should be common or listed on in mob apps anyway, so yeah. So that's that. So let's briefly try and go to what else is installed here. So there's a file sub, which might be, that's Nautilus, which is interesting because that's really rare on PinePhone OSs, and it's not really well adjusted, but I think it's actually usable. So these touch targets, of course, would be nicer if they were bigger, but looks like Nautilus works now on the PinePhone. It didn't used to. So this is a welcome change. Also, they have that funny King's Cross icon for the terminal here. And I could not try, I don't know. Is this the update command for OpenSUSE? Okay, I would need sudo. Maybe, so let's go sudo bang bang. Yeah, that worked. Now this terminal font doesn't seem to be a good choice. It reminds me of earlier builds of Manjaro Lumiri. But yeah, apparently I still remember the OpenSUSE bit command, so let's keep that running in the background and drain my mobile data. And then this here is the alarm clock, which also seems like it's a different version. And usually, yeah, that's a quite old one. So the latest release, which might be 3.38, is more mobile compliant. But then this year, you know, it works, I think. So if we were to add another place, I don't know, best somewhere where there's different... Does it work or what's going on here? San Francisco is what I'm going to type. Yeah. So let's add that. Yeah, see that it's daytime there. So different image. Yeah. Works again. The font. Not sure whether I really like it that much. So the flashlight app is still here. Okay. So, and apparently there's nothing to do because 15 package updates are not going to be installed for whatever reason. They really should change that font. Honestly, it doesn't work on the terminal at all. And then we've got a camera app, which is now apparently megapixels. Also is an improvement about previous versions, but doesn't seem to do anything here, so might be apparently broken currently. And then settings, we saw that earlier. Maybe let's just check again whether there's anything special in here. Okay, they added a displays menu, which makes it seem like nightlight, so I could switch that on currently. And then yeah, go by that manual schedule and let's see if it turns more warm here. Or whether it doesn't, whether it actually works. Doesn't seem to work, but that might be to a different graphics stack than what this GNOME settings app is actually expecting. And then removal media, I don't think I've seen that before. Printers. Okay, it's not available. Okay. Yeah, so this seems to be less customized than usual, more like it is on standard GNOME. And here it says OpenSUSE, SUSE Tumbleweed, Wayland. And now let's go to software updates, which is the last piece of software I'm going to have a look at here. And yeah, that seems to be working just fine. Now, let me see if this rings when I call it, because I don't have the time to actually edit this video for a long time. So I'm going to hold this off the screen. But you can see it's apparently... Hello, can you hear me? Yeah, looks like that phone calls are actually working. And I'm going to end this now. Great. I would presume that SMS also work. I'll test this off camera, and if it doesn't, I'm going to tell you. So this is a short second look at OpenSUSE for the PinePhone or Slim OS, and it seems to be improved by quite a bit, but there's still work that needs to be done. So thanks for watching and see you soon. Goodbye.